How are you?
When you're 50 years old, or a little more, you don't expect your life to change in the blink of an eye. When I promised the people of Mahiga, Kenya, that I'd help them bring clean water to their primary school, I didn't expect so much. Not a big celebration when I returned. Not such big results for the school. Somehow, that one water system turned into a whole lot more. To purify the water, we brought in electricity.
Oh, wow.
The power made it possible to build a computer lab. Within a couple of years, the school went from failing to one of the best in the district. My friend Joseph Mutangu and I, we felt like we'd joined hands across a wide ocean and made something really special happen. And that's when my life suddenly darted in a direction I never expected it to go.
Here we are today. Out of the ordinary schools, the 49 ordinary schools we have in Kenya West, this is the first primary school with electricity and a computer lab. I have a very big dream for this school here in Africa and in Kikuyu land. I can see it. We shall have St. Joseph Mahiga Secondary School. St. Joseph Mahiga.
Though I'd spent time with these kids, it never occurred to me that there was no secondary school for them to attend, and that for many of them, their education was about to end. It wasn't my idea to build a high school, but how could I say no? It all started with a tree, a small tree. In 2005, I was directing a film about Nobel laureates when Wangari Maathai won the Nobel Peace Prize. Wangari invited me to Kenya to plant trees with the Greenbelt Movement, her organization that's planted 30 million trees and reversed deforestation in wide swaths of Kenya.
And planting trees, you don't plant them today and harvest them tomorrow. You plant them today and you nurture them, you water them, you wait for the sun to do its part. And it may take a long time before you can get a fruit from that fruit tree.
I loved being with these women, but what I really wanted to do was plant trees at a school.
How's that?
That's how I met Joseph Mutangu, who took me for my first visit to the Mahiga Primary School. Mud floors, slat walls, wind and rain coming through. Despite all that, written at the top of every blackboard, the school's motto, hard work pays. After I planted that first tree, our nonprofit, the Nobility Project, sent a little money to build a water system, but they did all the work.
Congratulations. Thanks a lot. You did a good job.
I'm trying anyway.
Just 2 years after my first visit, with my little tree growing tall, I thought about this community's dream to build a high school.
We have 366 kids in the primary school up through level 8. When those kids finish right now, there's no more school for them to go to.
No more school for them to go.
So Turk calls from Kenya and says, we're going to build a high school? I thought he was nuts. We're a nonprofit. Filmmaking is our mission. Supporting educational issues, basic children's rights. And how does this two-person nonprofit handle building a high school in Kenya?
And we toss it way up in the air, and then we catch it.
By 2009, we had a new film about providing basic rights to children everywhere, and we wanted one piece at a time to be known as the movie that built a high school.
Did you know, they say in Africa, there is only one way of eating an elephant.
What is it?
One piece at a time.
Oh, that's great.
For some people, $10, that's a good donation. For some people, they could do $10,000. If you guys would do whatever you think is cool for those kids, I can promise you we'll build a school and great things will happen.
As soon as we announced we were going to build a high school, the community started the area's first ninth grade class. But a high school is more than classrooms. To collect enough drinking water for a bigger school, we wanted to build a rainwater court, a basketball court with a big roof, water storage tanks, and solar-powered purification. But even a half court would cost 50 grand, and high school kids need a full court to play on. That seemed like a good match for the Nike Game Changers Award, an international design competition uniting sports and social change. So the first step was to get a game changer to Mahiga.
This unit here, you can join together.
You know, we're doing a lot of sports projects around the world. If you have the land, if we can, we have a local team. Looks like we have a local team to work with. Okay. Then a preliminary, there's a few things we have to iron out, but we will do this. Yeah. So we will do the basketball court and collect the rainwater.
It's the best thing in the world to have Nike and Architecture for Humanity. I mean, it's so great. And the Nobility Project is ready. When we are ready with plans to start 12 classrooms and a computer lab, we'll find the money for the library. And when we get all that done, we'll go find the money for the science lab.
I think I should be able to say that the local leadership is in full support of what the Nobility Project is doing and their partners. And they would want to see how this can translate to a big impact around this community. And we really will be with you and assist you in whatever way that is possible. So we are really happy.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Also, we've asked Joseph to represent us and come up with a lot of solutions here. So
I think what Tuck's saying is if you have any problems,
go to Joseph.
Go to Joseph.
So the problem was.
While everyone knew Mahiga needed water, basketball was brand new for these kids, and our new homemade rim was barely bigger than the ball.
See, now, in basketball, you don't kick. You dribble, or you pass, catch. And you pass back, good. He's on my team, I pass to him, and he shoots.
Shoot. Yes!
Yeah! Try it.
Starting in 2003, primary school became free and mandatory to all kids in Kenya. Eight years later, there's a huge gap between the number of students graduating from primary school.
Congratulations.
And the number of high schools. There are also gaps in the number of qualified teachers. And since high school is not free, a gap in the ability of parents to pay tuition. The Mahiga School Committee wanted to find sponsors for orphans and other deserving students who couldn't afford the fees. And that makes them even more shy when I turn on the camera.
You want to see yourself in the camera? Before I start, make sure you look good.
No, no, I guess you can lean.
Yeah.
My name is Peter Chawairimu.
My name is James Dego.
What's your favorite subject?
Physics.
Biology.
How old are you?
I'm 16 years old.
Do you have any idea what you'd like to do work-wise?
Accountant.
And did you tell me?
A journalist.
A journalist?
Why?
Oh, okay. Come here.
Wait, come.
Come here. You hold the camera. Point at James. Now, when I move this, I'm going to get wider. Smile, James.
Like I didn't. Smile. How do you like it?
Come in the shot.
Yeah,
and you can. Okay, you want to ask any questions?
Yeah, as a journalist, you can ask any question. We'll try to answer.
Where do you come from?
I come from Texas.
Yeah.
Just hold it level like that.
Do you enjoy our country?
I love your country. It's really beautiful. This is my favorite part of the country. I like this area and the mountains. It's a nice spot. Nicer when it rains, though.
Yeah, it is.
Three years of drought was a little hard.
It was so hard.
Okay.
That's great.
That's great. Thanks. Okay, now when you want to stop, see the red button? And now push stop.
Along with construction money, the Game Changers Award provided an architect, a volunteer no less, who'd live in the community for the next year.
How did I end up in Kenya? I graduated from architecture school at North Dakota State.
And then Cameron Sinclair, the head of Architecture for Humanity, came over and spoke at our graduation ceremony, told him about some of my thesis work with low-income housing and construction background. And 3 months later, I was framing houses in Fargo, and I got a voicemail over lunch, and it was Cam asking me if I wanted to go to Kenya. I said yes.
When people ask me, how do you build a high school in Africa? I say, get yourself a hippie architect from Minnesota.
I moved out to Kenya, and then we started the design meetings, and I started just researching structures in the general area. We ran 4 community meetings and just bounced drawings back and forth based on what the community was saying.
So on one hand, we are happy because you want to be part of us. As a community here, that's the first thing. The next thing, all the support that you require from us and what we're able to do, we'll provide it. Even in the building or whatever you'll build, we'd want to be involved. They're saying they are very happy. That is the French.
We put the project out to bid to 6 different contractors. Ended up with Basilica Construction.
The first one was the toughest because after the putting the spot, you had to put another.
I was staying in Nyeri for the first month. I was in Kenya at a $7 hotel called Tickles. And I was looking for an apartment in Mahiga. And then Jared, the chairman of the school, had met the new priest here. And he offered to just let me stay here. This was the original priest compound when the church was built. When Mount Kenya is up, the high peak is right above the tip of this pine tree here, out in the distance. So it's a good spot to drink a cup of coffee in the morning. The name they gave me right when I arrived here is Maina. And that's just a really common Kikuyu name.
Maish.
And from there, the nickname for Maina is Maish. So all the kids out at the school call me Maish. Maish, Maish.
Back in the States, I hit the road as an advocate for the idea of every kid receiving a secondary education.
Well, there really is only one way to address these problems, and it is one piece at a time. If you want to make it personal, the question is, how do each of us fit into those solutions? Here I am filming at the Muharram. This is the Shia Festival of Ashura in Calcutta, India. You can see that I fit right in. Cameraman who took this picture said I look like a human Q-tip. Check out this guy's shirt. If you're looking for a big opportunity, seek out a big problem. So let's talk about education. It's estimated that it would cost $11 billion a year to educate every child and through grade 8. Every child in the world, $11 billion is what we're missing. For Americans, $11 billion is less than our military spends in 1 week, every week. But still, $11 billion is a big number, and we're all individuals. Let's talk about making it more personal.
So we actually think we have the question that's in the forefront of your mind at the moment.
That would be 6'7"?
5'1". People ask us, why these kids? And we say, why not these kids? We're a small organization, and we can't engage with every community in need, but we can with this one. We decided we'd find 1,000 people who were willing to donate $100, and we call it the 1,000 Voices for Hope. Willie Nelson was actually our first donor, and he said, that's a choir I want to sing in.
So let's watch our short film, 1,000 Voices for Hope.
Education shouldn't end after the 8th grade. Help us build Mahiga Hope High School. Join the choir. Be one of 1,000 Voices for Hope. By the time I returned to Kenya, we'd moved from design phase to the beginning of construction.
You can see they're fabbed to 2 pieces.
And my first day back at the school, we broke ground on the rainwater court, poured the foundation for the classroom and library building, and unpacked the first books from our campaign, 1,000 Books for Hope.
So welcome to Mahiga Hope High School. Just the surface dirt, not counting foundation trenches, it's 362 cubic meters of excavation. There's about 40 guys on site now waiting to get work excavating the beginning of the court. And it's good we've got 40 or more because we've got a lot of earth to move.
It's an official pouring day for the slab at the classroom building. It's going to be 2 stories tall, so it'll be eight classrooms, the library and the computer lab, and there are 40-something guys on site.
We're making a temporary fence. This is the line where the kids should not be able to get in over.
And on the other side of that line?
I just can't get over how big the structure actually is going to be. It's one thing to see it in the drawings, but...
It's noon, and not halfway finished yet. They've been working a long time, so see if they can make it today.
The guy in the tan shirt was one of the original class members at the high school. Wasn't interested in learning, wasn't interested in school, and dropped out. And I mean, here he is today, digging the ditch.
We launched a campaign back home called 1,000 Books for Hope. We asked people to donate their favorite book with a personal note inside.
Dear reader, my name is Carl Compel, and I live in Austin, Texas. This inspiring novel depicts the struggle of a young girl to find freedom.
She called to her friend.
And me, and now I see this corn is sweet. Corn for now.
Today, you can see all behind me, everywhere you look, you can see kids planting trees.
We got real lucky today. We got rain coming on either side of us. This back corner of the trench is actually going to have to go another meter lower. As soon as Friday or Saturday, they're going to have a steel set and be pouring the foundations in the bottom of these trenches. Yeah. Pretty amazing.
So it's about 5 o'clock, and I never thought it would happen, but 9 hours they managed to pour the entire slab. And the next time I come back, this thing will be on its second story. And that's just one day at Mahiga. It's kind of an exciting place. Mike, the bus driver, is navigating.
We haven't found yet, Mike.
We're stuck in the long rains. This is just one afternoon of rain after a short dry spell. And the lorries full of materials cannot get out to the site. No construction at all.
Might not be the easiest time to answer the phone.
Wow. Hooray! Applause, please!
This is the Mahiga way. When it's rainy, you can't get a vehicle in here. So I've been hiring a contractor and spending thousands of dollars to pave this road. Parents said, we'll do it. All total, we're looking at about 40 dump trucks before we're all done.
So we are putting the bollard here, so that leverage, so that the lorries will be able to get the materials to the site. So when the rain comes in, there'll be no matata. Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata.
How do you like it?
Perfect.
As the vision and the cost of the school grew, we spread the word to our friends that we couldn't do this without them. And on one amazing night in Austin, it seemed like everyone turned out to do their part. Of course, it's easier if you have the help of everyone's favorite Texan.
It is the Nobility Project, an artist and filmmaker dinner, a who's who gala, Lyle Lovett and Willie performing this evening here at the Four Seasons.
Turk and Christie do a lot of wonderful things around the world and a lot of people never hear about, but they've been busy.
From the Four Seasons, Andy Langer, News 8 Austin.
I would like to invite Nathan and Elise and Sophie, the triplets, to come up here on stage. They decided for their mitzvah project to raise some money for a new kitchen at Mahiga. Do we have a picture of the old kitchen that you can slide through to there? This new kitchen is going to feed 800 kids a day, and that's probably for the next 20 or 30 years.
Good evening. My name is Elise. This is my brother Nathan and my sister Sophie. The kids at the Mahiga Hope School deserve an education just as much as we do. We raised enough money to build a kitchen because, come on, who can learn on an empty stomach? I might be the smallest 13-year-old you've ever seen, but I know that I can make the biggest change. Thank you.
And look what these guys have got. Okay, so there's a truck ahead of us that is dragging a huge load of steel down the highway. Just guessing that it's going to Mahiga.
Back at the school, I was happy to see the classrooms were up to the second floor, but surprised to find the local school committee there too.
You can down with okay, yeah.
You know, we got the engineer, the architect, the electrician, and now we have the contractor and the board of the school. Mm-hmm. And why they're here is because they want to understand the classroom, whether it will be safe without current.
Make sure the second floor doesn't come down.
Exactly, that's why.
To guarantee the building was safe, we were using twice as much steel as we'd budgeted.
Roughly, what's the cost of the steel in the upper floor?
About 300,000.
And so we're probably looking at more of a number like double that?
What happened? Julius was working on those figures before he consults the engineers.
Yeah, before the engineer.
But later, while consulting engineers, he confirmed that we should not use two. We should go at minimum seven. That's what he said. So he instructed the chairman, Francis Mutongu, to count every bar that we bring here. Yeah, but for rates in money, in the changing of rates, right. I don't think it's at this time.
No, the rates aren't negotiable. Yeah, we need to get a real clear perspective of what the overage of the cost is going to imply.
Yeah.
Because it's going to require additional fundraising to pick up for that.
The quantity, it's higher than we put it.
Right.
It's going almost twice.
Twice just for the upper floor, or twice of the total?
Almost double.
No. Yeah. But the steel for the entire building, or the steel for the second floor?
Well, just for the slab.
Just for the slab.
The real question. Yes.
You see, that one is overage? A superstructure.
In shillings, how much were we short? And
he's the rough estimate was 200,000 shillings, so just under $3,000.
Bummer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Over budget on the classrooms didn't seem too bad compared to the rainwater court, where work had stopped completely.
The engineer was also the project manager and quantity surveyor, and he disappeared on us. Disappeared without quitting. Refuses to answer phone calls, emails, text messages. So we've been backed up about 3 weeks trying to find the new engineer.
Today's a big day at the school. Two ladies from the education district made their first trip ever to Mahiga Hope High School.
I have 2 A's. I have 2 A's.
So far, we're operating as an independent school. We need to become part of the Kenny West Education District and have them pay our teachers' salaries. It's a big deal to have to pay those salaries and build a school at the same time. And bottom line is, we don't have the funds to keep operating this school independently. So we need the education district. A lot rides on this.
The school must be operating.
Yeah, it is operating now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then we need to know the enrollment.
We should be having two classes. Two classes, is it? At least.
Two classes by each grade.
Mm-hmm. We really wanted the school district to say yes. We'll provide a principal and teachers. But the answer was no. We need 80 students enrolled, and we have to finish construction. Crazy day. They're still working on the second floor pour of the classroom building down there. It's a lot bigger than the foundation pour because it's suspended support for all the upper floor. The crew came from Nairobi, traveled all night long, slept 3 hours, 13, 14 hour pour, and then 3 hours back to Nairobi and probably work again tomorrow. Hardest working people I ever met in my life. Okay, so how much weight have you lost?
About 35 pounds.
35 pounds. Let's see the belt report, dude.
So that was college, that was India, and that's Kenya.
How long will it take to put it back on when you go home? A week and a half.
It's June now. I've been here for 9 months. I've definitely gotten used to living in Mahiga and staying at the guest house of a church.
Working in rural Africa is rewarding and it's fun, but it's not easy. In the same year, Greg and I had both survived head-on collisions on the bad local roads, and that was far from the worst thing that Greg had to deal with.
A group of local thugs busted up the church trying to get the collection money. I woke up to some screaming and some banging. And so I think what I heard was them working the door, getting into Daniel's place. I was in my bedroom, woke up to the noise out back, and then came in here, shut this gate, the riot gate. Gideon, the watchman, he was out in the field there, and they approached him, and he took off running. He slipped in the mud, and then they hit him in the head with a metal bar and a machete. He ended up in the hospital, Daniel ended up in the hospital, but they're both back, they're both safe. I was sitting on the floor in my bathroom with a pipe in my hand, but they never came through my door. It's not like at home where you can dial 911 and no one's coming to help you.
After the attack and all the delays, Greg could have given up and gone home. But his idea was reinforcements.
My girlfriend, Christina Tapper's here. That's gonna make the next 3 to 4 months in Kenya a whole lot more enjoyable than the first night.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine.
Yeah. Yes, mine, how are you?
Yeah, good. Congratulations. Christina's also an architect. She's gonna be here helping design the preschool, helping with some design stuff on the secondary school, and then she's gonna be working on the library.
A month behind schedule, we took the only logical step, a road trip. Hey Mike, are we there yet? There are great partnership programs all across Kenya, and we wanted to see how some of our friends are working with the people in their communities.
C-H-H-I-R-R-I.
Comfort the Children's work with special needs kids who are ignored across much of Africa is truly inspiring. Since joining CTC school, many of these kids have literally learned to take their first steps.
Nice. You like to walk?
Yes.
A lot of these kids were shut in their homes, and so we brought the kids out into the light here at the school,
And then we realized that a lot of the mothers now need a community. And so how we started the Mahiga Moms after we started the Mahiga Kids.
While the kids are in school, their mothers do commercial sewing, generating income for them and the program. CTC's work is focused on the idea of Ubuntu, I am because we are, mobilizing the community to take ownership of their own problems. Instead of a charity, CTC offers a hard-working hand of friendship.
I am because you are. Good job.
Hey, you guys, we may need some help. We don't really know where we're going. We need some help. Have you remember driving by the Automobile Association?
No, but I remember this bar on the way up.
In Nairobi, for the past 3 years, I've been documenting progress on a new community center in the Mukuru slum. Population, 400,000.
It has been a long journey getting to where we are right now. So welcome to Siderek, the technology and media lab done with the help of Architecture for Humanity, Global Studio, and Siderek. Originally, what we had were the Mabati structures that you see within the slum areas, and what we're giving them is a permanent home. In this building will be a cyber cafe on the ground floor, and then up we'll be having a radio studio. But that is coming in our next phase of works. And then it's going to be the ECD Center. ECD is the Early Childhood Development Program. So this will be now the new face of Siderek.
So Mike, how many kilometers you driving a year?
Yeah, I can cover like 100,000 kilometers.
100,000.
The last stop of our road trip gave me a chance to talk with youth counselor Alma Obama about the challenges facing nearly every kid in Kenya.
One of our key kind of statements is use what you have to get what you need. That is really the core of what we're trying to do with the young people. And the youth that I work with are teenagers and a bit older. So I'm telling them, what are you doing to change your community? What can you see in this community that can be changed to enable you all to have an income and to enable you to have a choice of staying in the rural area and not going to Nairobi and ending up in Kibera in a slum, you know, where you're basically living in squalor as opposed to living in this beautiful environment here. Many funders don't want to fund infrastructure because they say, oh, I'll help you put a kid through school and pay school fees, or I'll help this orphanage, or I'll help that. But actually putting infrastructure in place is key, because we can churn out young people who have had an opportunity within their environments to gain knowledge, gain expertise, gain confidence, gain awareness of themselves in terms of what they can achieve and how they can improve their communities. But it needs to start from where they come from.
The project of the secondary school started on 10th March. So far, it has taken about a month and a half, and we are hoping that the project is going to complete in time. We are expecting our children to join the classes by the third term.
Our goal at Mahiga was to build a model infrastructure for schools across rural Africa. Using hand-shaped stone, we were now building the classroom and library building, the rainwater court, kitchen and dining room, and science labs, with all the designs in the public domain for others to use. Whenever kids weren't in class, they were learning to play basketball. Still on a dirt court, with rocks,
dribble and shoot,
and no backboard.
Oh, almost.
Shall we show them a little 101? Okay, Greg, your turn.
Mike.
Yeah, good luck on that shot.
The netball we've been using, basketball, gonna be a little easier.
Luckily, our first adult mentor at the school was Esther Niaga, who had toured Africa playing for the Kenyan women's basketball team.
Basketball is a team sport. I step and pass, my arms are straight, defensive stance, down, jump stop right, ball, jump stop left, ball. Give yourselves a hand.
We're good at sports. We'll build you a place to play.
You've got mail.
Okay, so here's the deal. This is what I woke up to at 6 o'clock this morning. And
so this is from the builder.
It's really a shame that we didn't have this when we were there. I mean, we're only been back a day.
I know.
And now we're talking about $15,000 in expense that we should have been discussing.
Well, you know what? I think there's no. There may not be a coincidence in that.
Yeah. Dum da dum dum. How do I turn the speaker on?
There's a speaker button.
That was loud. You know, when the cost of the building goes up $15,000, no one wants to answer their phone. Rats. Any odds of whether he answers? I may have to go over there and answer Greg's phone for him.
Hello?
Hey, it's Turk.
Hey, Turk, how's it going?
Oh, it's going good. Did you ever get an answer from Julius why the original bid only had a third of the metal roof?
No. I think we're going to have to pretty much sort this one out ourselves. We're going to pay him what the contract says. We're going to pay him for each of these issues.
I don't want to start over with a new contractor. They've done a good job. So let's find a way to hold on to him. I'm sorry you're stuck having to deal with all this. It's too bad we didn't deal with it when I was there. So I should have stayed longer, I guess.
All right, Greg, hang in there.
Hey, thanks.
One advantage of all the travel to Kenya, I'd earned enough frequent flyer miles for our daughters to join Christy and me and finally meet the kids at Mahiga.
We have pretty much finished library downstairs. There's still the walls are plastered, waiting to put the door in. We're gonna build sidewalks out here. The rails are going in. It's pretty amazing. What are people saying in town?
Every time someone comes here, it's wow.
Our daughter Katie Rose is an artist and got to teach a class while we were there.
And an interesting thing about the eyes is that they line up with the top of your ears. So even though it doesn't seem like it, even though it seems like your ears should be higher, the top of your ears match this line.
We still had negotiated customs for shipping the 1,000 Books for Hope, so our daughter Lily had brought hers with her.
This book is a memory that I will always share with my father. Maybe it is a story you can share with yours, Lily Pitkin.
Ferdinand knew that he would not be picked, and he didn't care. So he went out
and smelled the flowers under his cork tree. Well, if you were a bumblebee and a bull sat on you, what would you do? It stung him.
When I first came to Mahiga, there were 8 kids in the preschool. But parents here had discovered that early learning may be the biggest single advantage they can provide for their kids. Every trip, I found that the number had grown. Now there were 40, ages 4 and 5, every bit as smart as they are cute. Mahiga would soon have a new preschool.
Welcome to the preschool. Right here is, it's 2 classrooms, the front classroom and the back classroom. The front classroom is for the older students, and the back classroom is for the younger students.
The height is about as tall as you.
The preschool would also have a second teacher to join teacher Tabby.
It will be very beautiful, and we are demanding to come here.
No matter what grade you're in, it's exciting to have your first school photo taken. A school photo proves that you're somebody, that you're part of something real. When I think back on all the stuff I learned in high school, it's a wonder I can think at all. And my lack of education hasn't hurt me none. I can read the writing.
When we were in Nairobi, found these things. I wouldn't say they're the highest quality desk and chairs I ever saw, but they'll work. We need 100 more eventually, but this will get us started. Here we go.
The Kenyan government has created vast game preserves to protect the country's wildlife. Revenue from tourism supports conservation, but game fences also mean that most of our Kenyan students had never seen the amazing animals that live just a few miles from their homes.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. We have a game sanctuary here. We have animals that I hope that you are going to enjoy. Who is going to replace the senior warden? Who is going to care for these animals? It is you.
Beautiful world, intricate web of design. Shadow and light playing out on the land.
With Kenya's wildlife helping attract over 1 million tourists every year, the country's economic future depends upon balancing opportunity for young people with a sustainable environment. The future of these natural wonders is truly in these kids' hands.
All this area used to be a forested area back in the 1970s, and used to be the migratory route for the elephants. But now, their migratory route have been taken over by the settlement.
They don't migrate at all.
Do you know who did that? It's not the animals. It's the most dangerous species. Do you know the most dangerous species in the whole world? Do you know it at all?
Man?
Yeah. But not me.
I'm going to England and I study conservation. But I say that knowledge, I have to come back here to Kenya because I need to save this country.
So it's a very important tree, and that's why we try to keep them.
I had a dream, if I could be on the ground with the kids, and then we can start to teach the kids right from the beginning, they can grow knowing how to conserve the nation.
How many are on the school committee? How many people?
We are 13.
13, and you're the chairman?
Yes, I'm the chairman. And I have three kids here.
Three here
yes.
at Mahiga?
Yes.
In what grades?
One is in class 7, the other one in class 5, and a small one in pre-unit.
Oh, in the nursery?
Yes.
They're my favorites. There they go!
The purpose of the school you see here is for the food. Early in the morning, the kids come in, the number of kids who are present is taken, and then the food is made according to the number of kids who are present. Each kid is supposed to take 40 grams of beans and 150 grams of maize.
One of our big challenges at the school was the kitchen. The tiny room with big open fires was constantly filled with caustic smoke. A major health hazard for cooks across the developing world who have a high incidence of smoke-induced lung disease and blindness.
When we build a new kitchen, we might have chimneys.
Chimneys is better.
There it'll be a new one.
Yeah, we're going to build a new kitchen.
Okay.
We only raised $10,000 for a new kitchen, so we hatched a two-phase plan to protect the cook's health and reduce wood consumption.
We are going to start the designing of the kitchen. We are going to take the measurements of this classroom, which will be converted to kitchen. Maybe early next week we'll be having the light design for the kitchen. Early next week.
Right, if this whole area is going to be stone all the way up.
Prop up the rafters and roof of this old termite-eaten wood classroom building and construct a new concrete and stone building beneath the roof. Then we'd replace the open fires with high-efficiency wood stoves that put 50% more heat directly in the pots and 99% of the smoke up the chimney.
After cutting it down, it was supposed to be 705.
Yeah. I was feeling fortunate to have the talents of great Kenyan architects who are committed to giving back to their communities.
I have a family in Nairobi, three kids, but I have a covenant with my own that I must bring back whatever little I'm earning in Nairobi back to our village level so that I can help those people. A big journey starts with one step. This is the first step. You can see, my friends, I went through what you are undergoing now. That's why I can stand in front of you and say, yes, it can be done. I was the 22nd kid in that family, and as I am the only one who is educated there, I was lucky to get educated.
Building a school, connecting with teachers and students, running the Nobility Project. Those were all full-time jobs for Christy, and she'd done it all while fighting breast cancer. Had Mahiga made that battle harder? We didn't know. Maybe Mahiga had made her well.
Mugabe.
7?
Juele.
Juele.
Gerardo.
Gerardo is Gerardo. Juice.
Juice, I remember it. How about
Timbo?
Thank you.
Nuega.
Nuega?
Yes.
Oh, Nuega.
Tereza.
What's your name?
What's your name?
My name is Christy.
Christy.
Mm-hmm. How many years
are you? That's why, how old am I?
Yeah.
Do you really want to know?
Yeah.
51.
And you still look so young.
Oh, thank you. What grade are you in? What year in school?
Six.
Eight. You're the biggest kids.
Yes. Yeah.
So next year, high school.
Yeah.
Wow.
You want to go here?
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. You want to go to Mahiga Hope?
Yeah.
Yes.
Mahiga Hope.
Come and help us.
Good. Good. Good.
I will. You want to show me?
Just like that.
Just like that.
These are my new friends.
So I asked George Abraham, the student here at Mahiga Hope High School in Kenya, to write us a little bit about his hopes and dreams. And it says, I have great plans after my high school education. First and foremost, it is to work hard in high school so as to get a scholarship in one of the best universities in Kenya. For the higher one proceeds in education, the better the future. Ever since I was a child, my great heartily interest was to become a journalist. My parents are not financially stable. They really want to see me performing and aiming higher in life. My future goals will keep shining like a star in my heart with the support from friends and family. I will fulfill my dream and I won't let anything stand in my way. So that's why we do it. I like that.
Hey, how's everything going?
All right.
That's George. George is my cameraman. He's shooting flip video coverage of everything that happens here when I'm not here.
We put George on a journalism scholarship. And George's dad was really happy about it.
How are you today?
I'm very fine.
Wanted to stop and say hi.
Hi, welcome.
George is doing really good, huh?
Yeah, it's doing good. I appreciate the help of Mr.
He's going to make good grades and we're going to cover the whole way through.
Thank you very much.
Okay?
I appreciate it.
All right, man. Sawa, sawa.
How are you?
Take the flip.
For the next month, while I was back in the States, George was going to shoot the raising of the rainwater court.
Put it all on this hard drive and organize it. When we come back, this will be your segment in the movie.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you.
Cool.
I guess we're 2 months behind the original schedule.
Yeah.
On the rainwater court.
On the rainwater court, yeah.
I mean, it took 8 guys to move half of a truss. The light half, and more like 12 guys to move the heavy half of the truss and then bolt it together. They built a giant wooden scaffold system just out of 2 to 3 inch diameter eucalyptus poles. This thing was over 30 feet high, and it was 7 meters by, I think, 4 meters at the base. It was a concrete hoist on top of this tower. We did a test pick, just slowly lift the truss off the ground. The operator got up there and just hammered on the controls, raised it. There was lots of cursing, but mainly the message was, put that f***ing truss on the ground, now. Bounced on the ground, and then he dropped it. Got to slam face forward. At that point, we just about called off the whole operation. Then a big safety meeting and really came up with a plan of who was going to be holding the ropes, how the ropes were going to be placed, just a slowly by slowly method of raising the trusses.
take these off.
Greg, I want you to tell me why you're drinking sodas.
Oh, we're having sodas and cigarettes because we just completed the 8th truss on the Mahiga Rainwater Court. So we're having a celebration. Cheers.
With the court nearly done, we needed tanks to store the 30,000 liters of water that would fall on the roof with every 2 inches of rain. The solution was 2 huge ferro cement tanks, a reliable long-term solution from a crew who really knew what they were doing. All good, if only it would rain.
Greg, let's hear that entertainer again one more time here.
The good news was starting to come fast.
It's so touchy.
After 6 months of trying to figure out the customs regulations for shipping to Kenya, the 1,000 donated books were finally leaving Austin, and we were in the process of buying another 1,000 books in Kenya. After a year and a half of planning and construction, it was great to see Mike waiting for us as we arrived for the grand opening of Mahiga Hope High. It all started with a tree, at least for me. But truthfully, Mahiga Hope High School started with a small group of Kenyans who'd been the lucky ones. Who'd received a high school education, which had launched them forward in life, but which had also brought them home again to give back to their communities. Together, we tried to build a model school for rural Africa. We'd done it on a budget, almost, and with the grand opening just a few hours away, we were almost finished.
Well, this is about as exciting as it gets. We're down to putting signs on the door. Check out this drill bit, it's a nail.
We have a regularly very few schools have, and I just like a dream come true.
So good to meet you. It's
a pleasure too.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Karibu.
Santi.
You know that.
My name is Jane Wainaina. I'm very happy to be the first principal of this school. You know our language. Mahiga means stones. And stones are obstacles most of the times. And then I said, this is a school which has so many obstacles, but there is hope.
Flowers, 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 drop. Flowers, 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 drop. Drop.
I'm here on behalf of the Environmental Club. We have planted some flowers, trees, and everything that will make our environment look good. Some people who are going to have cameras, and then they will take pictures of the things that are happening in the school. Because some of us may want to be journalists when they finish school. When you're in the Environmental Club, you will be trying to pursue your dreams, and then you'll help the environment.
I'm a senior in Scouts Club. We normally do scouting here.
PY is a scout, a leader, a winner.
I am the game's captain. We are going to continue practicing and praying more and more better.
I want to thank our visitors for what they have done to this school.
We promise that we are going to work hard.
Let's use the facility the best we can.
We have a rainwater court, of which after the games we can take the purified water. We have 14 computers. We have our stocked library. I don't have words to say thank you. So, for our students, make them proud.
Raise up your light heart. We are going to do our best.
We are going to do our best.
In academic.
In academic.
And co-curricular activities.
And co-curricular activities.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Within the first 1 month, the students will be more than 100. We are going to work very hard so that we can make this school a center of excellence. Now we have good lab, it is well equipped, the grades will go up. And I believe come next year, when we have our pioneers sitting for Kenya Certificate of Secondary Education, we'll get good grades. And some of our students will join university, and others maybe tertiary colleges. That's our prayer.
Well, the tower is a lot taller than that.
I know, I mean, it must
be. So this half of the roof is one slope, so it comes straight down to the first tank. Second half of the roof will come across the full 2 feet.
Two drops what?
So this drops down to the roof line and into the second tank. Hey, how you doing, man? You can see the concept with the yellow. You know, everything yellow is water, so any component with water is yellow. Again, these are the same tank from outside, and this 1,000-liter storage is for completely clean and pure drinking water.
Is this the first time they've ever dribbled on concrete, huh?
Yeah. So now hopefully we get a backboard up.
15 months, then it comes down to 2 hours to put up a backboard. What's he doing?
Grinding right into the court with the grinder.
It's like, oh, now we can chip that up and redo that again.
If we can't drill holes the right size, use the bolts at work and let's keep moving.
When Joseph first brought me to Mahiga, his youngest daughter, Miriam, wasn't even born.
She told me that the Mahiga is our school and that's where I'll be going to school.
I'm very happy to be here for the ribbon cutting of this great rainwater court. More than 1,000 individual donors joined hands to help build this great school. And now it's up to all of you to help hold it up.
Teachers, parents, and all my fellow students, on the stage is Mahiga Hope High School.
The opportunity has arrived. For now, we will get educated. It's now.
People say there's poverty here, and there may be financial poverty here, but I see that you are very, very rich in courage and in strength and in spirit. And I am inspired by your community, and I thank you for letting me be a part of it.
Moriaga, Nubayamai Yagashagi Kiyamahiga. That's about all the kikuyu I have today, but when I arrived, all that was here was a dirt field, and I came as a stranger. And I'm standing here now, we're in this beautiful space, and I'm no longer a stranger, I'm part of the community with all of you. It's really the community that built this project, and we built it together. And I want to come over here, buddy.
best part. The rainwater court, it's never been rained on before. The tanks were finished and the gutters were done, and the rain is coming. This game may be ended by the tanks filling up.
Sometimes I think that love is somewhere, living on an island all alone.
It has been almost 2 months since it rained out. So the first water drop on the raindrop was yesterday.
I can feel it in the darkness. I can see it in the distance. And then it's gone. Know that it is time for me to go and find my favorite girl. 'Cause when I look into her eyes, I see all the love there is in all the world. And it always will be. And it always will be.
Together, we'd built a school that would serve this community for generations.
And it always will be.
We hope to inspire others to do the same and give thousands of kids a real chance in life.
And it always will be.
Will it work? We don't know yet, but we have hope.
Yeah.